Hi folks, Will from MinIO here. This companion video is for our replication series. In this video, we're going to take a look at some example code that you can use to set up replication between two buckets. We're also going to show you how you can set up multi-site replication that's going to use three different MinIO deployments to actually replicate data actively across all of them. Let's go ahead and take a look at some code. So first up, we have a couple of different servers set up, and we need to make a couple of buckets on those servers. So here we've got MinIO 1, MinIO 2. I've also got a MinIO 3 and a MinIO 4. But for right now, we're going to do an MCMB. That's going to make our bucket. This is going to be MinIO 1 bucket REPL. And that's just the name of the bucket that we're giving it there. We're also going to do an MCMB MinIO 2. Bucket REPL. Now, I'm going to set up replication between these two buckets. Right now, there's no replication set up. I do not have to have the exact same bucket name to do replication. I can, as you'll see, set up replication between two buckets of any given name that I want to use. But in order to do any kind of replication, you have to have versioning turned on. And remember from our versioning series, the versioning is not turned on automatically when you make a bucket. So I need to actually enable that. So we're going to do an MC version enable, and we're going to enable it on MinIO 1 bucket REPL. Okay, I'm going to do the exact same command for MinIO 2 bucket REPL because they both need to have versioning turned on, and we're set. So from here, we're going to upload a file to MinIO 1. So if I do an MCCP, I have a sample text file right here. We're going to upload that to MinIO 1 bucket REPL, and our object name is going to be REPL1.txt. That's just our object name. So if I go ahead and run that, my REPL1.txt is uploaded to MinIO 1. So if I do an MCLS MinIO 1 bucket REPL, there is my file. If I do the same command on MinIO 2, nothing there yet. Obviously, I haven't set up replication. Let's go ahead and set up replication then. MC replicate is the command. We are adding a replication rule, and we are adding it to MinIO 1 bucket REPL. Okay. I'm going to do a line continuation because this next piece is kind of long. In order to do this, I actually need to hand it the remote bucket information. Now that's going to include the fully qualified domain name, it's going to include the credentials, and it's going to include the bucket name on our remote server. Now, I can't use aliases, right? MC lets me use aliases for all this stuff. I can't use an alias in this case because I'm actually telling the bucket on the MinIO 1 server where to replicate to, and the MinIO 1 server has no idea what my aliases are. So when I do this, I need to do dash dash remote bucket. And when I do this dash dash remote bucket, I'm going to give it the fully qualified HTTPS. It's going to go to MinIO admin, MinIO admin. That's the default. You obviously do not want to leave the defaults running when you actually stand this up yourself. But this is going to go to MinIO 2 API. And here is the rest of the stuff. Okay. I could also add a replicate flag to this and only replicate certain things, but I want to replicate the entire bucket. So I'm going to go ahead and hit that command and let it go. Replication configuration rule added to MinIO 1 bucket REPL successfully. I can list my rules. So if I do an MC replicate list MinIO 1 bucket REPL, what do I get back? Because I need to do MCLS. There we go. So there is my rule. It's my one rule. It's pointing out to MinIO 1 API. It's got a rule ID. I can use that rule ID to make edits to the rule, whatever else I need to do. And that allows me to see what active rules are running on my server. And since we have this rule in place, let's go ahead and take a look at MCLS MinIO 2 bucket REPL. Okay. And when I run that command, well, guess what? There it is. REPL1.txt has now been replicated. I can get some more information about this should I want to. If I wanted to do an MC stat MinIO 1 bucket REPL. REPL1.txt. And when I do that stat, what do I see? I see replication status is completed. If I do the same command on MinIO 2, I see that this is the replica. So in this way, I can tell the difference between the original and the replica object. Now, This also makes sure that MinIO does not start replicating stuff back and forth infinitely. How would it do that? Well, one of the things you can set up very easily with MinIO is you can set up active-active replication, which will allow you to upload an object to either MinIO 1 or MinIO 2 and have it replicated to the other server. The way that you set up this replication is very simple. I just need to use the same command that I used on MinIO 1 on MinIO 2. So let me do a clear. So we're going to go ahead and redo this the other direction with mc replicate add MinIO 2, in this case, bucket REPL. And our remote bucket command is now going to go in the opposite direction. We're going to point it back at MinIO 1 instead of keeping it pointed at MinIO 2, obviously, because it can't replicate onto the same server. So there is our remote bucket. Again, MinIO admin. You do not want to use that in a live environment, but we're pointing this to MinIO 1 and we're using bucket REPL. So now I have rules going in both directions. So I can get an mc replicate ls MinIO 2 bucket REPL. And I can see that I have a rule there pointing back to MinIO 1. And just as a reminder, I have the same thing on MinIO 1 pointing to MinIO 2. Okay, they have different rule IDs. Obviously, they're on different servers. But this allows me to see that I have my rules enabled and that they are active. So now that we have this active-active replication set up, let's try uploading objects to both sides and see what happens. So we're going to do an mccp. We're going to upload sample text to MinIO 1 bucket REPL. And I'm going to call this one active 1 is my object name, active 1 text. I'm going to do the same command again, but I'm going to upload it, instead of uploading it to MinIO 1, I'm going to upload it to MinIO 2, and I'm going to call it active 2. So if I do an mcls on MinIO 1, bucket REPL, we are going to see active 1, which I just uploaded there. We're going to see REPL 1, which was already there. And we also see active 2. Similarly, if I just reverse the order, I'm going to see all the same stuff on MinIO 2 as well. So this allows me to have this active-active replication going both directions. The question, of course, becomes which one's the original, which one's the copy. That is where, again, mcstat comes in. mcstat, MinIO 1, bucket, REPL, active 1. For that object, that says completed, it is replicated. If I check active 2, that one says replica, so that's the replica. If I change this back to 1 and I take a look at it on MinIO 2, well, that's the replica on MinIO 2, but if I look at active 2, that is the original. It says completed, okay? So I can tell very easily which is the replica, which is the original. This also allows MinIO to keep track of which is the replica, which is the original, so I don't have circular replication going on, infinite loops going on or anything like that. The nice thing about this is that I can add a third server, a MinIO 3. I can add another bucket to this replication. I just need to make sure that I have rules pointing in all the directions, and then I'm in good shape. Let's clear this up, and we're going to test one more thing. And what we're going to do is we're going to do an mcls MinIO 1 bucket REPL. And notice we still have REPL 1 there. I'm going to go ahead and do an mcrm MinIO 1, bucket REPL, REPL 1, dot text. I'm going to remove that object. Okay. So notice that it created a delete marker. If I do it mcls on MinIO 1, bucket REPL, now I just see active 1 and active 2. REPL is now gone. But what if I take a look at it on MinIO 2? On MinIO 2, it is also gone. The delete marker got replicated. How do I know that? Let me add versions to this. There it is. I have a delete marker for REPL 1. So it gets deleted. The delete marker gets propagated. Okay. If I deleted the specific version, that would be replicated as well. Everything gets replicated. Okay. But this allows me to see that I have replication of my deletions. I have replication of my objects. Everything is being replicated quite nicely. Now that takes care of bucket replication. We're going to pause here. We're going to end this video. In our next video, we're going to take a look at site replication. I hope you've enjoyed this video though. And if you have and would like to talk with us, you can reach out to us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. Or you can Slack us on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for site replication.